Hi guys. Now I know this is not the norm. We never really do this unless I'm doing like a wear test day. But really, what's the norm right now? Nothing. So we're gonna make it a new norm. Now I did promise you guys, we're gonna try this professional right here. This baby is the star of the show right now. We're gonna apply him, put the phone down, the one that I'm holding right here, because yeah, I have to hold it because I'm not supposed to be having like a tripod here at work. I don't know, I guess it's like bad taste maybe or something. Who knows? And I will start to apply it, and then I'll pick the phone back up and let you resume our regular scheduled program. Hope that sounds good. Okay. I've applied this much on my hand. And as I mentioned, you don't have to apply primer in areas that you don't need it. I like to work from the center out. Now, as you notice, the more I touch my face, the pinker it gets. Not my fault, people, not my fault. First impression, it's super greasy, you guys. I'm not into the super greasiness. It's not my thing. It's not my latte, okay? My latte is a nice blurring that doesn't feel like I'm rubbing a lard stick on my face. Just go ahead and say what you wanna say about me. I know what I like, and I don't like lard sticks, okay? It doesn't feel tacky. It feels a little slick and a little smooth. Did it blur anything? Man, I don't know. You know, we're gonna have to put the makeup on with it and see how that works. I'm sorry about the shadows. There are a few shadows. Looks like I've got, you know, bruise on my face or something, but I don't. It's just a shadow of the phone. I guess maybe it's a little bit blurring. I don't know. Not enough for me to be like, wow, you know? I did strategically put my concealer where I wanted it, and that is this Il Makiage concealer. I am enjoying this one quite a bit, so I wanna give you guys a full good review on it. To me, it blends out really well. I just put concealer where I need it. You guys, it's just to conceal. It's not to load up all over the face, you know? I think this day and age, everyone forgets what they're doing, and they just wanna do the in thing, and it's like, you know, drawing these pyramids under your face. If you don't need that much product, don't do it. I do it to kind of cover up this little baggage area and some of my pinkish tones. But other than that, I don't ever do these insane pyramid drawings underneath my eyes. So you see, I just put one more dot here and one more dot here just to lighten that a little bit more. And I put two little dots right here. That's it. You don't go crazy, you know? It blends out really well. If you're not seeing it with your own eyes, I don't know what to tell you, people. I don't know. We are trying out this Il Makiage foundation. This is called the Woke Up Like This foundation. And this particular shade right here is shade 60. If you think you're more of my tone, it's shade 60. As you notice, I like to always start down the center and blend out. Always using a damp beauty sponge. I thoroughly enjoy this little tiny baby egg beauty sponge. Typically, I would use a little bit bigger one when I'm doing my entire face. This one's really, really good for the eye area. I didn't bring any other beauty sponges with me today, so he's gonna have to do. He's working overtime. If you can see, I hate these stinking shadows. If you can see, it's not fully matte, but it's also not skin-like, you know? It's kind of like it sits somewhere in between. I do like to see, you know, a little bit of a dew. Just do a little bit of dew. I'm gonna give you guys a full review on it. We're just showing you today in this little vlog that I'm doing because it's just a spur of the moment thing. So just show you stuff. We're gonna go in with a tiny bit of this Ciate London translucent powder. We're gonna see how this guy works, okay? Now I'm gonna get this brush right here, and this is by the Opulent Beauty. It also came in my BoxyCharm. And I do like this because it fits really good right here, and it is super duper soft. And we're just going to lightly, I'm telling you lightly, okay? Just kind of gracing your face, you know, just nice and graceful, like making sure to get right in this area. Because if you lightly powder that area, it's less likely to crease on you. I don't notice that it oxidizes too much, and that's also a plus because you don't like when you get your shade and you think it looks awesome, and then it oxidizes like a few minutes later, or sometimes even later than that. Sometimes like an hour later, you see that you're like yellowish or something. That's not fun. We're not walking around looking like lemons, okay? I do get in pretty close, you guys, not trying to freak you out or scare you off, but I just want you to kind of see the skin and kind of see what everything's doing. Next, what I'm gonna do is get some of this Tarte. This one seems like it's kind of deep, but I'm gonna try it out anyway, and I might not be able to hold up my phone the whole time because my arm wants to break. Let's feel bad for my arm, okay? Pretty pigmented. See what it looks like right here. Now remember this, you guys. The first place that you're gonna touch your face with the product is gonna be the most intense, okay? So remember that. If you wanna have really crazy rosy cheeks, go all for it. You know, just attack that guy. Show who's boss. I don't. I'm not Raggedy Ann, I don't. So I will always start from the back and kind of work my way forward. Just kind of tapping it out a little bit. That's not bad. It's not. I'm not a blush girl. I'm not. You guys know this about me already. So I don't go, you know, balls to the wall with the darn blush. I just don't. But I'm just showing you guys because that's what I'm here for. Just because I don't like it doesn't mean that you don't like it. So we've got to be, you know, we've got to be open. We've got to be open to try things and, you know, do what other people like too. We don't want to be selfish. Who cares if I hate it, you know? To me, that's perfect. That's fine. We're going to leave it like that. Leave well enough alone.
Just learn to do that, okay?
I have to give my arm a rest. I swear I'm not trying to shove you up my nose. Do you guys have it where one side of your face you can do much more easier and you can see much more better, and then the other side is like why do you feel like you're so far away, you know, like a different area code? Because this side of my face I can just barely turn it and I can see everything. This side of my face I feel like I'm cracking my neck and my eye can only look so far. Am I the only one that's like this far off from being symmetrical? I know I'm a little screwed up, but am I that screwed up? I don't want it all up in the nose area. I'm not Rudolph. I'm not doing that. No, we're not doing the sick nose. You can come across here, you know? I think coming across the bridge of your nose is okay. Doing a red nose tip, I don't get it. I just don't get it. Why? Why?
It is what it is, and it's what's trending.
Next, we're gonna add a little bit of this iconic London. It is a nice glow, look at that. And that's the good thing, is you can move the product. Like, I can still have time to blend it. Use a little bit of the Gerard Cosmetics on the eyes for the primer. Don't need a whole lot, you guys. You really don't. The more product you take on the eyes, the harder it is going to be to blend everything out. I don't know why people think that they need to coat it like you're putting a jacket on when it's summertime, all right? Just put a little light coat, just enough to cancel out any unwanted tones or veins and to give you a nice smooth base. That's all we need, guys. If you want more of a pop with your colors, get a lighter base. You know, they have white, they have all kinds. I just wait like about a minute or two for it to set completely. We're gonna do a simple look right now, you guys, with this blush crush. The purpose of the look today is just to use those brushes that came in the BoxyCharm yesterday. I wanna try them out, see how they are. See if they're worth $30 or $29.99. Let's not add a penny where it doesn't belong, okay? The Lavish 5-piece brush set. And we're not gonna go by the way they look or the way they feel or how plasticky they seem. We're gonna go by the performance of them and how the actual brush itself works. That's the point of the video. Can't judge a book by its cover. Unless the book sucks. Okay, this is the only one that makes sense to go in with because it's the biggest, fluffiest one there. This isn't very big. When I say big, I'm using that word loosely, okay? This is pretty small. It's pretty small. I'm gonna go into this one right here. Just make sure that you tap out any little creases that may have arisen, arose, whatever. The brush feels soft. It doesn't feel tough or prickly or any of those unpleasant feelings. It doesn't look like it's picking up too much product. This is very plasticky, okay? So it feels almost like a toy, like something I would give my daughters to try and learn with. The brush itself, I don't like to base things off of what they look like. I like to base it off of what it actually does, how it performs. And you know, all joking aside, it's not impressing me. We're gonna go in with a deeper tone now in the crease. This is more of a crease brush anyway. And remember, the first place you apply is the first place you're gonna get the initial color, okay? If you don't want too much color over here, don't start here, start in back. The brush just feels very flimsy. I can't think of a better word for it right now, but flimsy is about as good as we're gonna get. Cause you know your girl with the words don't come to me. As soon as I stop filming, oh my gosh, I'm flooded with descriptive words, with entertaining words, with all kinds of words. But when I'm filming, I'm like a dingbat. So here's a learning tip, okay? Typically, good 90% of the time, I like to do my eyes first before I do the rest of my face, because right now I wanna make a clean, crisp line. And if I did my eyes first, I could've just got a little bit of makeup remover or a makeup wipe, and I could've just wiped it away, simple as that. Now, since I have foundation and concealer and primer and everybody else on, I have to dab a little bit and try to just create a little line, try to make it crisp again, and I can't just wipe it away. Problems that we could have avoided, okay? Cut it off. Here we're gonna use a smudger brush right here, and this one seems like it would work pretty good. I'm hopeful for it, but don't expect things, just don't. This brush right here actually already feels really soft under the eye, and that's what you want. You don't want a blender brush that's gonna tear up your under eye. Nobody wants that, trust me. This pencil brush, it's very pointy, and I don't know, I'm just trying it out on my skin, and it hurts a little bit. I'm gonna use it just to apply some highlight right here when I'm done, but this is not a brush I'm gonna be reaching for, I'm gonna tell you right now. That pointy end on it, I don't know if you can see it or not, and it does not feel comfortable. And I care about comfort, okay? Okay. We'll use a spoolie guy to go ahead and just brush up these lovely hairs. I mean, if you hear it, it's like you're brushing my actual hair on my head. That's how thick my eyebrows are. People want thick eyebrows, but when you have them, you're like, do I need them to be that thick? And this is because I've tweezed out and waxed all the forest underneath. And that's for y'all's sake, okay? Because sometimes I can get a little lazy and I don't really care. And my eyebrows will be down to here. All right, truth. Now I'm gonna use this side, the flat angled brush, and line the eyes. And this is gonna be really hard because I need like a mirror. It's very precise, but I wanna show you guys what it looks like instead of just doing it off camera. From right here, I'm gonna just like flick it out. That brush, even though it's flat, it kind of bends a little bit, and I did have a little bit of trouble trying to have a crisp line. It kind of goes along with the way the blender brush was. It just has so much movement to it. The only brush so far that I do enjoy more is that smudger brush, and I could kind of tell right off the bat that I was gonna like that guy better. It is what it is. I speaketh the truth. It's just hard to hold this phone up the whole time, you know? Okay, you guys, it's about a whole entire hour and 42 minutes that it's taken me to do this simple look. Yeah. I went ahead and finished off the eyes with a little bit of a tight line with some black eyeliner. I did not pull it out or wing it out. I went ahead and used my It Cosmetics mascara because I miss my mascara. Been trying other guys and not giving it any love, so I heard it calling to me saying, hello. Like a little echo in my ear. So I went ahead and I used it. Went ahead and used this nude sticks right here. I put that on the lips. As far as that primer, I can't tell if it did any extra smoothing, but I'm gonna wear it all day long and see how it comes out. I went ahead and used this little dangerous pointy guy, and I popped some of that Stila right there on the inner corner. It's okay, it's just really, it's a little sharp. I don't wanna bash the company, never heard of them before. Morphe brushes work better than that. And it's just, there's so many other brushes that are inexpensive that you don't have to spend $29.99 on 5 brushes that don't really function properly the way you need them to. I do like that little, you know, topper of shimmer with the Iconic London. You could go much more heavier, you guys. I just didn't, you know, I didn't go so heavy today because my arm hurts. The longer I take, the longer I hold the phone.
So yeah, my arm's telling me stop.
So I'm gonna stop now, and I'll come back and check in with you guys when I get home. All right, bye. Hey you guys, it is the end of the night. It's about 1:30 in the morning and I'm home from work, sitting in my comfy chair, trying to just unwind before taking a shower. I'm not too sure if the primer did anything any different because my face actually feels the same way it did yesterday when I had my foundation and my makeup on and everything else. But having said that, I think I still look good. That might be just my opinion. But yeah, I do kind of think highly of myself sometimes, except for my cracked lips. It's like 140 degrees. It feels like 200 degrees. This is a lot of the highlight that I used. That's why you see that extra shimmer, which I do enjoy that highlight quite a bit, I will say. The brushes are just okay. Would I go out and purchase them? No, I would not, because I'm not gonna spend money on something that I know I can get something better for $7.99. You know, I can get a Morphe brush way better for $8. Some are $6. So it's like, why would I do that to myself? Spend 30 bucks on a 5-piece brush set that two of the brushes I won't use at all. What am I gonna do with it? I don't know. I gotta be real, people. We gotta be realistic. This Nude Sticks lipstick, it's okay when you apply it on top of other lipstick. I believe it lasts better that way, and it feels probably better that way. When I just apply it by itself, it just stays greasy. Anyway, that's all I can say about that. I do think that maybe the Porefssional helped with the pores a little bit. I don't know, you guys. I mean, I look pretty smooth right here. I mean, you guys make your own judgments about it. Il Makiage Concealer, I'm really enjoying that. I think that works as well. And the foundation is just, it's okay, as you can see. I mean, there's nothing bad about it. You can't tell on the camera, but this area right here is a little dry. But I do like that it doesn't cake up in this area. As you can see, I don't have any cakiness there. It looks pretty good. Just a little wear test day for you guys today. Just trying out all those little products, put them all to the work. A lot of stuff was in the BoxyCharm. So I always tell you guys, I will do a review. I will do a wear test when I can. And that was today for you guys. Doesn't look bad? We're gonna end the night on a good note. That's always great. Have a good note. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna go take a shower now because your girl needs a shower. Just a little bit. Just letting you guys know, be positive, guys. I know it's hard and I know times are tough and I know you wanna get crabby and cranky and yell at your neighbors who aren't doing anything because they're not even outside. I know, I feel you, I do, okay? But just be positive. Things will pass, okay? This too shall pass. But I'm gonna remind you one thing. Just because the president decided to open beaches and open malls and all that nonsense doesn't mean you have to rush and bombard the places, okay? I personally feel like the more distance that we give these attraction places, the better. You know, because just because this stuff has died down a little bit doesn't mean it's run its course. I mean, when you get all together and everybody gets in groups together and starts going about like everything's fine, that's when you cause havoc, okay? That's when things start to get more ugly and then you have a rebound. Like, we need to just kind of heal. And I think the best way for us to heal is to allow time and to allow this to thoroughly pass. Look, just because someone says you can do it doesn't mean you should do it, okay? Just because your car goes 160 miles an hour doesn't mean you should go 160 miles an hour, okay? This isn't NASCAR. We're not on a racetrack that goes around making a left all day long, okay? Why put yourself at risk and do something just because someone else said, oh, well, you know what? I think it's safe now. They also want to put bleach in people's veins. So, you know, I mean,
let's think about this for a minute, okay?
I'm not trying to tell you what to do, because we all know that's not good. Don't tell people what to do. You do you, boo, you do you. That's just my opinion. That's my theory. That's my logic. You know, just kind of chill. You know, we want to be alive to see the next day. So I think we should take that into consideration. Life is very precious and it can pass you by very quickly. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm not gonna preach. I'm just saying, love your life, love your kids, love your family, love everybody, love yourself, all right? Care for yourself. So I care for all of you. I don't wanna see anybody get sick or anybody get hurt. So you guys do the best that you can for yourself and I'll see you guys next time, okay? Bye. I'm actually pretty impressed with my makeup, Papa. My makeup, Papa. Papa? Jeez, man, I can never talk. No matter what time it is, I just can't talk. We're gonna get through this together. Just hold on. It comes off and it transfers pretty much really, what's the word I'm looking for? I don't know. I never know. The very first color I put all over as my transition. I just cannot talk, for God's sake. The first, why is this sentence so hard to say? Why?